How's it going, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of the Port Vale Youth Academy Legends Career Mode here on FIFA 19. We are making our way towards the back end of the season now. We're in March, and in this episode we're going to make our way into April as we play Brighton at home, Spurs at home, Huddersfield away, and Southampton at home. So three home games. Decent. So we'll make our way into April, and then just after that there's going to be just two more episodes because there's four games here for the next episode and three games here for the episode after. So we're getting close to the end of this first Premier League season, and as you can see, we currently sit in seventh. We've had a massive resurgence since switching back to the 4-2-4. We were like down in this area, like 16th, 17th sort of area at the start of the season, and then we just had some massive results, and yeah, we now find ourselves in seventh, just 4 points off fourth place, which isn't bad at all. But I suppose, yeah, let's get on with this, shall we, and play against Brighton. So these are the two teams that will take part in this game. A little bit of a switch up in both sides. We've got Isaac White coming in for Guillaume, Wang Wang in for Hugh Harris, Mehdi Abu-Hamed in for Fernandez, and I put Cristobal Cortez back in his natural position on the right wing. I've only played him there once, and I just thought I'd try him out again, just because why not? So yeah, let's go. It's actually been a while since I've played any sort of FIFA whatsoever. I'm really just not into FIFA at the moment. I mean, if I'm not into FIFA, I still love doing this series. This series has just been amazing to do. Whether I'm into FIFA or not, whether I hate FIFA, whether I love FIFA, this series, I've always loved doing it. So it's just fun. But yeah, it's been a good couple of weeks since I played. Well, last time I recorded this series, which was like 1 or 2 weeks ago, was the last time I played FIFA, as Nunes gets a ball in and headed away by the defender. He's just wrestled him over. Ref, hello. It's Van Hinkle. And Jokeres and Brighton have the lead. Jokeres gets it in the top corner. Simple turn and shoot. And Brighton take the lead here. Damn it. And Johan Baxter's got clear of Schiavi, and he's got so much more pace than Schiavi as well. He gets the ball in, and Jokeres again. That is a very good save from Atunan. That is a very good save. How did he keep hold of that? Oh, Cortez. Oh, hello. That's probably the best piece of skill you can do, considering you only have one-star skills. It's Dylan. Oh, wow. What a goal. Dylan bringing out the long shots. Wow. See, even Inacio's proud of that. He's just like, yes, Dylan, mate. What a strike. He just touched that and bang. Oof. I like that. What a hit. Into the box towards Dylan. It's punched away by Ryan. Schiavi to Wang Wang. Cuts back onto his left. He's not going to get anything done with that, though. Cortez ball in. Dylan saved by Matt Ryan. Bingham. Here goes Wilson. Joel Wilson. You know, he's going to have to smash himself. Straight at the keeper. I was waiting for Dylan to get in a good position, but he just never did. So in the end, I just had to hit it with Wilson himself. Inacio to put it in. Isaac White. Oh, Johan Baxter, what have you... What have you done? What just happened? Johan Baxter took it off his keeper, and then Manzala tried to head it back to Ryan, and Bingham got there just before Ryan cuz, and slotted it in. What a defensive calamity that is from Brighton. That's Archie Bingham's first goal in a few months, to be fair, so he needed that. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. I didn't commentate over that because I wasn't expecting anything to come of that. What a goal. That's almost straight from the kickoff. What a goal. I don't even know what was so good about that goal. It was the pass. It was the pass there from Cortez. And Dylan hitting it with his weaker foot and scoring it. Wow. Oh, dear. No. Jahan Bakhsh. Yes, Atunin. Yes, mate. Jahan Bakhsh heads on to Ayoub. And Jokeres. Oh, he's passed it straight to Inacio. And that is full time. We did not look like we were going to win this game until we scored the second goal, really. Well, that put us in the lead, but I suppose, actually, no, it's when the second half started. We came out a much better side than we did in the first half, that's for sure. And we've ended up beating Brighton by 3-1. Dylan getting another 2 of those. He's now up to 11 for the season. So this is a bigger game than first thought, actually. We beat Spurs, we go level on points with them, and they're in fifth. So, unless, obviously, of course, if Crystal Palace win, then we're still 3 points behind fifth. But, hey, it's... This is a big game. Right, so... Spurs at home. Tottenham are absolutely stacked in terms of their team. I completely forgot how stacked they really were. We've got a full strength, first team, apart from Skiarvi at left back. So let's go. Onyekuru, oh, I've just taken him out there. I didn't mean to do that, but it just happened. And Paul Pogba's the one standing over the free kick. How long is this run up going to take? Not very long, because Mariano took it instead. Mariano, it's Lo Celso. And the player that Tottenham could be signing in real life has given them the lead against me in FIFA. Giovanni Lo Celso getting the goal. That's a great finish from him. That is a good finish from him. Curling, bending efforts. First time. Fully outstretched goalkeeper. Could do nothing about it. Brilliant goal from Tottenham. It's 1-0 to them. Look at that. Oh, the technique from Lo Celso. It's Tolisso. Lo Celso. And Balde. And it's going to fall for Mariano. And it's going to be 2-0 to Tottenham. Ah, oh, one of those lucky bounces off the post, eh? And Mariano decides to celebrate in front of me, the little prick. Oh, for flip's sake. Luckily, Heung-min Son's hit the post, but that's just how this game's been. I can't pass the ball. I can't touch the ball. Yeah, definitely dynamic difficulty adjustment here from EA. It's Archie Bingham. Oh, nice run. Oh, that's only our second shot of the game. And it's come just before the final whistle. How Tottenham only won that 2-0, I don't know. That should have been 5 or 6-0. That was just the worst game ever. But again, it shows why we are not ready to get in the top 4 or 5 or 6. We're just not ready for that yet. We'll hopefully be looking for an easier time in this game against Huddersfield away. They're the teams. I've made a couple of changes. Wilson's in for Nunes, Alexander's in for Byrne, and Harris is in for Vertonghen. Huddersfield's team is definitely a bit more beatable than Spurs. So, yeah, let's go and beat these people. Ramadan Sobhi on the corner for Huddersfield. It's cleared away by Will Hill. This is Ryman. Daily, it's Sobhi. Oh, and Turin puts it wide just about. Did that take a deflection or? Yeah, it did. That took a slight nick off Ewan Alexander. As they put the ball in, and a guy called Trusty won that header. I didn't even notice him in the squad when I was doing the teams. How about this casual replying to comments mid-episode, because I've only just realised I forgot to do them. There we go. I loved them all, and then forgot to bloody reply to any of them. That's just typical me. I put my own comment in because I actually failed with editing. As Fernandez nearly scores. Yeah, I only noticed it when after uploading it, but there was a point in the last episode where there was a whole chunk of that I just forgot to cut out. Like, when I played the Chelsea game, I didn't cut out between showing you the teams and the first goal of the game. I just left it all in, like, completely by mistake. But, I mean, still watched it. I mean, it, you know, nothing really happened. Wilson, It's a great run from him. Will Hill back post. Oh! Both he and the keeper missed that. Still got a chance though. Oh, and it's this time it's going to go out for a throw into us, I think. Inacio Rakitić, he's in space. You know what? Bang! Oh my.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Dylan, here we go. This could be the chance. And it is. Dylan gets a goal. Finally breaks a deadlock in this very, very crap game of football. I mean, that's straight to the point, isn't it? It's been a very crap game of football. It's been like watching two teams at the bottom of the Premier League go head-to-head, when only one of them really is. And, good finish in the end from Dylan. 1-0. There we go, full-time here in Huddersfield, and we've beaten them by 1-0 in a very dull game of football. Yeah. Huddersfield brought us down to their level. I'm not going to say that, no. It was just a very bad game. But we came out of it with 3 points. It was a scrappy 1-0 win. I don't know why, but I felt like just giving this game, with it being a Tuesday night game and we're not really playing for that much, at least in my opinion anyway, I just felt like giving some players a game who either I've not played before or just don't get games ever. So we've also got our first 90 rated player, and that is the Emil Hatunen, the goalkeeper, who I haven't trained since we were in League One, by the way. At least I don't remember it anyway. I haven't trained him this season. So we've got him in goal. We've got Harkey, Byrne, Max Evans and Rakitić at the back. Inacio and Simon Velasquez as the centre midfielders. And Tahir Ersoy, Bang Wang, Dylan and Nicky Vieira Nan up front. Don't know why I've done this. I'm probably going to get absolutely smacked, but whatever. Let's go. This is money here. Oh, it's through for Kennedy, and we're already 1-0 down. Oh God, that was way too easy. The defence was split wide open with that pass from money here. And Kennedy slots it home. 1-0 to Southampton. This is Dylan through for Bang Wang. And it's Velasquez. Oh my God. Just 13 minutes into his debut. And Simon Velasquez has got his first goal. And what a goal it was as well. I haven't even got a flipping goal graphic for him yet. I need to make one. You'll see it now as I'm talking. What a finish that is for Velasquez. And it's Cunha, and Atun makes the save. Wow. This game is weird. I don't know why. It just feels so weird. I think it's because I'm using players I don't normally use. I just feel like I'm not using... It's not the same team. And Yerry Mina has made it 2-1 to Southampton. For God's sake. Kibier and Nan to Dylan. Bang Wang. To Ersoy. Inacio gets it back in there. Velasquez to Dylan. Bang Wang went for the header. It came for Velasquez. It's come for Inacio! Oh, and what would a Vale episode be without an Inacio long shot? That's the first shot he's had, pretty much, I think. On the fly as well. Brilliant effort. Dipping and curling away from Nick Pope. Made the save, though. Inacio. It's Dylan. It's Velasquez again. Wow, what is going on with this guy? I know it wasn't a goal, but it was a flipping close to a goal. Wilson puts it in. Archie Bingham's there, and he comes to the back post. And finally, Atu Harkey has the goal. He got one taken away from him in the last episode, but this time, this is 100% his goal. Surely it is his goal. Hey, finally, it's only the second goal he's ever scored for us. I did look to see how many he had scored for us. He's only scored once. Now, twice. Here he is again. He's had a shot this time. Yeah. I just thought he scored one long shot, sort of, and he's hit the bar with another. Might as well try it for the last one. But it's a 2-2 draw against Southampton. Brilliant game. What a debut for Simon Velasquez in the midfield. great game in the end. 2-2. Good game. And that, guys, is going to end off this episode of the Port Vale Youth Academy Legends Career Mode. We're still in 7th. We're 4 points behind 5th. I still don't think we've got anything to play for. I don't see us finishing 5th, to be honest. So, yeah. But we're not getting relegated. We're about to play Leicester, who will get relegated, probably. And yeah, they've lost... Oh, no, they haven't. Nottingham Forest have lost the most. Leicester have lost the next most. But yeah, guys, if you guys enjoyed it, make sure to smash that like button down below. Subscribe if you're new and you like what you see. And if you want to see more and don't want to miss it, then hit that little bell next to subscribe button and you will get told by YouTube when I upload when it decides to work properly. Until next time, guys. Peace.